down. We got this week and next week gonna be our last weeks here on the Panther Show. We will see us again next school year, like maybe during the summer or after the summer. So it's been a good run. Christian has been here with us a few times. You know, he does do a little bit of work with help producing the show behind the scenes. He comes up with good topics to talk about, stuff like that. So I don't know, brother Christian, man, is it in? You got any shots you want to get out before we get started?
Shout out to my mom, my dad, my sisters, and Brother Eric.
Yeah, Brother Christian comes from a BASA family. You know, he got the whole crew coming to Barber A. Sizemore Academy. So, how long have you been over at Barber A. Sizemore Academy?
A year and a half.
Year and a half. You like it over there?
Yeah.
So, I mean, what school, where were you at before that?
Mays.
Okay, I've heard a few things about Mays. I ain't here to bash no schools or nothing, but I'm just going to ask Brother Christian. Like, how does it compare, you think, going to, like, a regular CPS school where you learn stuff and going, but compare that to going to, like, a Betty Shabazz International Charter School. What are some of the things extra you get over there?
Science experiments.
Science? Oh, so that's one of your favorite tell us, I mean, science experiments, like what? What have you done recently in science?
Recently, we have done a chemical reaction project, elephant toothpaste, and it produced heat. And, like, we brought all the chemicals together, and for the whole experiment to actually come together, we used yeast and water, and when we poured it in, we had to count down to how long it took for the science experiment to rise.
So the elements you had some yeast.
We had yeast, laundry detergent, hydrogen peroxide, food coloring, and water. And did I say laundry detergent?
Yeah. So a chemical reaction happens when you start mixing some of these chemicals.
Yeah.
And what does it look like, toothpaste or something? Because you call it elephant toothpaste.
No, it looks nothing like toothpaste. It looks like a bunch of shaving cream with coloring.
Shaving cream with coloring. So tell, what else? I always see a lot of kids walking around with slime. Is that something else y'all make in science?
We made that with our last teacher, Mama Portia. We made that with her.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
I still see some of the kids walking around the school with slime, though.
Oh,
they making it on their own?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, who's the science teacher that you have now?
Mama Tasia.
Mama Tasia. She's been working with y'all for a few weeks now, right?
Yeah.
And you like Mama Tasia?
Mm-hmm.
She good. I know one time I walked in there, she had all y'all's attention. I think that was why y'all was, when you were about to make the elephant toothpaste or something. It looked like y'all were really listening. I mean, is that something that you want to, science, is that one of your strong subjects?
It's not one of my strongest subjects.
Mm-hmm. But you like it, though.
Yeah.
What's your strongest subject up there?
I would say reading. Yeah, reading.
Reading?
Yeah.
You a good reader?
Yeah, I'm a good reader.
I mean, but it's one of your strong points.
Yeah.
You read more than just your phone? Because I know y'all be up into them phones. You read more than your phone? You pick up a book and actually crack it open?
I'm almost done with a series of books.
I see somebody in the background doing like this, like, nah, he don't be reading.
Yes, I do. I read three books out of five. I think it's like five or six books in the whole series, and I read three of them.
I know your sister, I don't know if any of our viewers know, but my other co-host that I have on here, Kyra, is, oh yeah, you guys did an episode together. That's Christian's sister. So I know they have like academic battles and challenges going on sometimes, don't y'all?
Yes.
Seeing who can get the best grades.
Yes, and sometimes we have battles like with all our like talents with our grandparents, and we try to see who can win the most money.
y'all have like a little family talent show.
Yeah, and it'll be me, my cousins, Kyra, and Kamaya, and we're all like show off our talents on whoever win get $5, and we try to see who can get the most. And last time, it was a tie between me and Kyara, so we had to split the money.
What did you do? What was your talent?
I sung a song and Kyara danced.
Okay. Speaking of Kyara dancing, let's go on and cut to a video real quick. The video, it plays a little fast, but you can kind of see what Miss Kyara does in her spare time. Oh, dang, my bad. Just a little taste of Miss Kyara. She get out dancing. So, speaking of dancing, tell us about some of the artistic things you guys do over there at BASA. You all have like dance, music, digital media. Like, how do you feel about some of that stuff? Are those some of your strong areas?
Actually, your digital media media arts class, mm-hmm, and Mama Tiana's class is, to me, the most helpful class, mm-hmm, because Mama Tiana, she actually tells me and shows me that I am a good singer and, mm-hmm, I can go somewhere in life with that. And you do the same thing, and you actually help me kind of produce my music, and we're in the process of getting my music actually out there. So you and Mama Tiana...
Yeah, you want to do a music video, right?
Yeah, so you and Mama Tiana are very helpful in the process of me trying to start.
Well, that's good. I appreciate it. You know, I mean, I'm always trying to help. This is my first year teaching over there at Barbe Sizemore, so I'm still kind of getting used to some of the students and getting to know them a little better, kind of seeing where their talents may lie. Brother Christian, you know, he is a very talented singer. I don't really see you dancing too much. I remember I did see you do something at the last showcase. What were y'all doing at that last showcase?
Mama Koya, she gave us a routine.
You were representing the kids. Should I play that?
You got that up there?
I think it was on YouTube. But you know what? I got y'all in the circle. I play y'all in the circle.
But for that one, I was actually kind of nervous because I had to yell, like, mostly everything. But and from that day, the only thing that I remember is the steps in the day that it was founded.
Yeah, so we learned a little bit. Well, what they learned... just to tell you a little bit about how we do it over there, I have the students for about 5 weeks, and then I had Christian's 7th grade class for about 5 weeks, and in that 5 weeks, we learned about sororities and fraternities, and learned about HBCUs and where sororities and fraternities got their start at the black college. I'm talking about the black sororities and fraternities, mostly the Divine Nine. And so they learned a little bit about that, building up to like a showcase. So during that time, in that 5 weeks, they get a little bit of history about all those topics, and then they start working on some routines. A couple of them did some steps, and so we put you in the fraternity. What fraternity did you represent? Omega Sci-Fi. So how I did it in my class is I broke them up into different groups, into 9 different groups, and each group was represented a sorority or a fraternity, and
my group was the only group that did a step.
Yeah, so his that's only because we had other classes doing some steps and we didn't want to like overdo it. So my class was only responsible for one step. But they did do, I gave you a few quizzes. We watched a few little short films about the stuff. You worked on a poster board where they got a little bit creative. And then we had a showcase and everybody presented something. So, but before we go any further, I do need to get back to let everybody know that you're watching the Panther Show that's brought to you by Barbara A. Sizemore Academy. We are located at 6547 South Stewart Avenue, Chicago, Illinois, 60621. You can reach us by phone at 773-651-1661. You also can reach us on the web at www.bsics.org. And so just back to the showcase thing, they were... They learned a few steps. Let me go on and play a quick little step. I'm trying to remember the one Kyra was in.
Right there.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah, so let's give you another dose. Amazing right there. They did an excellent job. What did you think about that?
I liked it a lot.
I heard you say that a lot of people around campus liked that, right?
Yes, they liked the whole sixth grade step. They liked the zetas and the deltas.
Yeah, so I gotta say it's a lot of talented kids over at Barbara A. Sizemore Academy. And I want to give a special shout out to Betty Shabazz International Charter School System, the whole system, because they have another campus over on 78th and Ellis. That is the flagship school, the main campus, Betty Shabazz Charter School. And it's a very, very good school. They've been around, we're going on almost 20 years now. It'll be 20 years that they've been in existence. And so I want to give a special shout out to them as well. You probably will be seeing some of their youth on the show maybe next season. So it's just a lot of talent all the way around. And one thing I do like about being able to bring what I do as far as video, audio, and video production, a lot of the youth, they gravitate towards that, and it kind of brings out, it helps them, I believe it helps them academically, because it gives them, just a lot of coordination and a lot of social skills, because they are talking in front of the camera. They learn a lot of technical skills. They learn about sound and basically just digital media. A lot of the youth, y'all are already familiar with media because you use like Instagram and Facebook and all that type of stuff. So, I mean, you are, a lot of them are very savvy with on the technical side. I mean, what about you, Christian? Like, your technical skills as far as like computer and all that stuff, is that, are those things that you're interested in? Like,
I'm kind of good at it because some things technical wise I can fix and some things I can't. Like, I can switch the screen of a phone. That's probably the only thing.
But what I would like to do, like what we'll probably do next year, see, a lot of these youth are on these phones, but a lot of these schools don't teach them how to build apps. Would that be something you'd be interested in?
Yes.
I mean, learning how to create your own Instagram, your own Facebook. And it's become a lot easier than when, because when I was coming up, you know, and computers was hitting the scene, you had to know a lot of coding and how to code things, you know, on the technical side. But nowadays, a lot of things they do the coding for you. It's just drag and drop. I mean, you can build a website right now in like 10 minutes if you want. But I just want to, like, I'll tell Christian a little story about myself. Like, when I was your age, you're what, like 12 now? Yes. Okay, yes. When I was 12, computers were just coming out, you know what I mean? Like, they didn't have like these flat screens and all the type of fast internet and all that type of stuff. Computers were just hitting the scene, and my mother, she used to always tell me, she was into a lot of the technical stuff because she had kind of like a technical job. So when there was some kind of new technology that came out, she at least knew about it. She might have not could afford to get it and bring it into the house all the time, but she at least knew about it, and she tried to share that with me and at least let me know those things. But she used to always say, like, boy, this thing right here, when she bought a computer, she said, this thing right here is going to be the wave of the future, and I want you to learn how to do it. And I would be like, man, where the football at? I want to go outside. Because back then, you know, that's what we did. We just went outside a lot. We didn't have cell phones and computers. So we had to create a lot of our things, going outside, building ramps for your bike, you know, you jumping and doing all kind of stuff. But then she used to sit me down and be like, boy, you gonna learn how to use this computer. And at the time, I was like, I don't know what she talking about, but I'll sit down for 30 minutes and do a little click here, type a little something here. And I never knew how big it was gonna get.
Yeah, my parents were kind of on me like that when I told them that I wanted to do music. Like, when I want to do something that I want to do, they'll pull me to the side and be like, if you don't get over here and start practicing this music or learn how to do something with your music or practice working on your vocals, like, they'll send me to the side and start talking to me. So,
yeah, I mean, that's what it takes. I mean, Michael Jordan didn't get to be the best by sitting watching everybody else. He was out there when everybody else was like, yo, bro, you want to go to the movies? He was like, nah, man, I'm about to go to the gym. So those are some of the sacrifices that a lot of the youth I see, they don't take that into account. In order to be good and the best at something, you got to practice. You're not going to be good your first time. That's one thing I try to teach my daughter, because my daughter gets frustrated with stuff real easy. You know, she thinks she's going to be able to pick up something and be the best at it the first time she do it. And it's like, no, it don't work like that. You have to practice and get better at it. And that's how just things work. That's across the board with anything, whether it be school, whether it be riding a bike, whether it be just the best at anything it is you want to do. It takes a little practice. So I'm going to ask Brother Christian a few more questions before we get out of here. But are there any other things that you enjoy? Like, what do you like to do outside of school? Enough of BASA. What do you like to do when you get home? And where were some of your other talents, hidden talents at?
I don't really get, well...
You don't go outside? Like, you don't have a bike when the summertime? You don't go get on the bike and ride around the block? Or
no, because in the summer, it's actually me and Kyra's birthday. So, we don't really be in the house over the summer. We're really out somewhere.
In the streets.
Yeah, we're either at a hotel or somewhere during the summer. We
trying to have fun at swimming pool.
Yeah, we ain't never. Either we at the pool, the park, somewhere. We ain't never really in the house or in the summertime.
Yeah, I can feel that. I mean, I really wasn't in the house. What about like a summer camp? Have y'all done a summer camp before?
No.
I mean, is that something that you would be interested in?
At first I was, but then I figured out that you can get a summer job at the age of 13.
Mm-hmm.
So right now, I think Kyra is looking into getting into a summer camp, but mm-hmm. I'm looking into getting a summer job.
Summer, you want to make some money.
Yeah.
Well, one thing I would like to say, I mean, that's good. I'd like to always promote entrepreneurism, you know. A brother like Christian at his age, you know, he can't go apply at McDonald's or nothing like that. He can't even really, I don't even think you can do one summer Chicago with where they hire teens. I think you might have to be 14 or 15 for that. But I always promote entrepreneurism. Basically, you know, being able to create your own job. You know what I mean? Like back in the day, you used to could go shovel some snow or cut some old person's grass or something, you know, go carry some groceries for, you know, the grandma or somebody in the neighborhood, and they hit you with $5-$10 in a couple days. So, I mean, are you, well, I was going to say, like, there's a lot of festivals going on. I would recommend, you know, like, with some of the festivals going on, you can, like, set you up a little table, a little booth, and, you know, have something to sell. So do you like doing stuff like that, you know, like trying to create
stuff?
Selling stuff and like creating your own kind of environment for making money and stuff.
Yeah, because when you said cutting grass, that actually just reminded me that my parents and my grandparents want me to cut my grandparents' grass as a summer job this summer.
Okay, yeah, that's good. I mean, it keeps you busy.
Yeah.
You know, but that's good. You know, Christian is one of my good students up there. He always got something positive, you know. He talk a little bit too much sometimes in my class, but he all right. He a good kid. You know, I've had some a lot worse than this brother right here. But I think Christian is a good example of just some good upbringing. You know, he got some good parents at home, you know, that care about him. You know, I was just telling him on the way over here, you know, they tell me a lot about some of their problems they have. But I was just telling him, I wasn't just saying, like, it's a lot of kids out there with worse problems than you. You know, they come home and open the cabinet, there ain't nothing up there to eat. You know, so a lot of youth need to think about that, you know, sometimes. You think about all those problems you have, it's somebody out there worse than you. Man, they about to boot us up out of here, Brother Christian. It's we got one more episode. I want to thank Kyra. I want to thank Bryson and Martell, Renaya, all the staff at BASA. I want to thank Brother Christian for coming and sitting in and being a great co-host. I want to thank everybody, and I want you to tune in again next week at the same time, 6 o'clock, for the Panther Show. Peace.
Peace.